There's huge plans for this episode. We get the space station self-sufficient, return to the planet's surface, modify our mothership for mining ice, and, quite likely, stir up a little trouble with the Assert Faction. The question is this expedition to the planet a good idea or a bad one? Looks like we're gonna find out right now. So this is a big expedition, but I need to finish off a few things. First thing is to finish off this last wall of the space station. Now, I do want a large door on this, and I think the way to go about it is to frame out the door, kind of mimicking the big door on the engineering level, and then project the blueprint of the wall I've used on the other parts of the upper deck. I'll weld around the door, turn off the projector, then weld up the door area. So let's get on with it. Okay, that bit done. The next bit is to also add a couple more guns to the station. The backside still needed two. And now that the solar array is in place, I'll probably block the line of sight from the guns on that side. So I think I can remedy that with some guns on the ends of these conveyor tubes. I actually anticipated needing guns or something out on the ends, which is why I framed it out with conveyor tubes. So now it seems perfect. Okay, with that done, it's time to get the actual mothership ready. I'm unloading the ship with almost all the ore, ingots, and components. I'm just gonna take a couple hundred of each thing with me for emergencies, partially because I need as much space as possible for ice. But second is that I'm reasonably confident I'll be able to harvest whatever resources I need if I get into a situation. I've also decided I'm gonna move off four of the hydrogen tanks to the hydrogen storage on the base. I have six large hydrogen tanks total on the mothership, and with the hydrogen I'll have left, it'll leave me with about 1.5 tanks of hydrogen, which for landing back on the planet should be plenty. Lastly, I'm changing out the hydrogen miner for my large grid hydrogen fighter. If I do run into the Assert Faction, I think it's a good idea to have some readily available mobile firepower. The mothership itself is pretty well bristled with guns, but I might have to go out and take an outpost that's spawning drones, like I did at the Space Pirate Space. So, it's time to go. I thought about doing a convert ship to station to ensure that the space station would still be in this position when I got back. But to keep the challenges of this series going, I've decided not to. And I'll use the hydrogen thrusters and gyroscopes to help hold the thing in place till I get back. This is a little bit of a risk itself, as the whole system of thrusters is completely untested. So I'm firing it up and taking off, but I trust it enough not to completely fail. On the mothership, it's time to disconnect and unmerge the ship from where it's been anchored for weeks now. I did add back the landing gear I took off all the way back at the beginning of the space station build, and added a drilling array with an extra control chair. But this is brilliant, exactly what the space station and mothership were all for, to have a main base of operations and also be able to take the big ship out for major excursions. With a closure of the main hangar doors, we're off. It's a little ways down to the ice lake, so while en route, I'll tell you about what I did with my custom turret controller, or at least its display. Because I was mining ice, I wanted to keep an eye on the total weight of my ship plus cargo, and see how that was looking relative to the lifting capacity of my ship in full gravity. So on this display, I'm showing the total lift of my atmospheric thrusters, hydrogen thrusters, and both combined, realizing that the atmospheric ones lose power at higher altitudes. I'm also displaying the total mass of the ship that'll change as I load it up. I also unloaded the four hydrogen tanks so I could turn the first few batches of ice directly into hydrogen and save all that ice weight. I'm adding that total capacity of hydrogen on this display, similar to what I have on the central part of the ship. So I'm just cutting and pasting that from the other LCD while I'm in transit here. I better keep an eye out for asteroids though. That would definitely be a quick end to the expedition. All right, we're getting close, and as much as possible, I'm trying to go without dampeners and coast to save fuel. But I need to be careful here, as I don't have a feel for at all for how this ship handles an atmosphere and gravity. I've got my engines partitioned out on different buttons to turn different ones on and off. I just got to take it nice and easy. Okay, so there's the ice lake. Time to bring it into the base. It actually feels good to be back here. This wasn't my first base, but it was an important one before I took off for the moon. I honestly had no idea it was going to take me this long to come back. All right, we're set down. Now for a few adjustments to this connector and we'll be good to go. I think I'll move near the other side of the ice lake, mine some ice, and see how it goes. Okay, so I've spent a little time fiddling around with this drilling rig and trying to make it automated. And I figured I'd use the new event controller blocks. Before, I had used either timer blocks or sensors to make something like the hinge swing back and forth. But I wanted to use the event controller and see how that works. I did get a little fooled by this block though. The event you need to select for a hinge is the angle changed. And I interpreted that to be the amount of change in degrees the hinge would register before activating the desired action. But that's not really what it was. With my original interpretation, if I wanted the rig to swing all the way from one side to the other, the change in angle would be 180 degrees. It would swing all the way from one side to the other, completing a 180 degree arc. Activate the event controller, and then reverse the direction to swing back the other way. But that's not correct. It turned out it wasn't so much the angle changed value, but more the specific value of the hinge. So if the hinge was all the way in one direction, the value is 90 degrees. And when it swings all the way back the other way, it's negative 90 degrees. So really, I needed two event controllers, one that would activate at 90 degrees and the other that would activate at negative 90. With that in place and getting the right vertical push of the piston down, I'm off to mining. So I think I'm going to be a little conservative here and not try to max out my carrying capacity on this first load. I'm going to stop here at about 75% lift of my atmospheric thrusters alone and get the ship back to the base and docked and start converting this ice into hydrogen while my batteries charge up. This will be a good test of the whole mechanism. Okay, everything's doing great. It's time to get some more ice. I also moved my large grid fighter to a better place on the rear of the ship where it could use a connector. Where I had it before, it was just locked down with a mag plate, but that wouldn't allow it to get loaded with hydrogen. So I think this spot will be better. All right, so this time I'm gonna push the capacity a little farther and go slightly beyond the lifting capacity of my atmospheric thrusters. Yeah, I am not able to lift off at all at full thrust with the atmospheric thrusters alone. So let's add in the hydrogen. We got some lift. Let's see what happens when I turn off the hydrogen thrusters. Okay, perfect. We're sinking, just like I thought. We'll kick back in those hydrogen boys and get on back to the base. So while that ice has been processing, I've had a new idea. I'm using the first couple loads of ice to process it into hydrogen to fill the four tanks I emptied before leaving the space station. But why not go ahead and fill more tanks and bring back all the hydrogen I need to completely fill the space station, along with some extra ice? To do that, all I need to do is build some extra hydrogen tanks, but I'm having a problem. I didn't bring many resources with me for this kind of building, and I'm even cannibalizing parts of the ship that I'm not using, and disassembling some components that I have in excess. For some reason, I came here with over 1,500 construction components, and no iron ingots. So that's a problem. I was able to build a couple hydrogen tanks, but I'm just running out of resources. This isn't sustainable. Now I have two options. I could just take the mothership and go mine a little bit of rock and process that, or even swap out the welder on my little atmospheric ship and just go grab a little material and do the same. But I'm gonna roll the dice and live life on the edge a little bit and probably stir up some trouble. I've been seeing these Assert Faction ships fly a few thousand kilometers past where I'm sitting. So I think I'm gonna go after one of them with my large grid fighter. Try to shoot it down, and then salvage what I need from whatever's left on the ground. Yes, I'm sure this will make the Assert Faction very unhappy, and they're likely to retaliate, but it's part of the challenge I've set up in this playthrough. We're not going to be playing it safe the whole time. Okay, so there's one not too far away. Let's get after it. A few artillery shots at range should be enough to at least take it out of commission. There, it's down. One more shot for good measure because I don't want to get riddled by any Gatling turrets that are still alive. And then we'll start our salvage. Now, for some reason, this ship is being incredibly sluggish here in gravity. I really thought the two hydrogen engines in each direction would be plenty, but I could have accidentally left the mothership with a bunch of ice in the cargo containers that got shoved in there while I was mining. So that was a mistake, not to check the inventory and get myself cleared out. I think I'll go back, get the small grid atmospheric ship, and come back to get this wreck, because that small grid ship does have a lot of lift capacity for its size. What I've also noticed, and the Assert faction wasted no time in getting itself set up, but they seem to have already planted an observer base halfway between my salvage wreck and my little base. The scoundrels. But it's all right. We'll give them a wide berth so we don't appear too threatening and try to complete this salvage job. But you'll have to tune in next time to see if we're successful, because this episode is coming to an end, and you'll have to tune in next time to see if we made a big mistake stirring up the hornet's nest, or if it was a brilliant and daring maneuver. See you next time.